I don't know if you guys are familiar with Gary Vee or Gary Vaynerchuk, if you will, but sometimes during his talks, he'll be like, how many of you in the audience, when you first met me or first heard about me, you thought I was completely full of crap? And you see a bunch of hands go up, and I was definitely one of those people. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel is all about mental health. And what I like to do is pull different topics from the YouTube community to try to teach you how to improve your mental and emotional well-being. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. Now, Gary Vee has a ton of books, but did you know that I got some books too? So my most recent book, Rewire Your Anger, and the next one is Rewire Your Anxiety, which I'm working on. Rewire Your Anger is now available on Audible, okay? It took a while to figure out how to get it up on Audible, but it's finally up over there. So if you are an Audible listener like I am, go check it out. It's over on Audible. I think it's like less than $5. I think it's like $4.87, something like that. And it's about, I think the recording narrated by myself, it's like an hour and some odd minutes, something like that. But anyways, the link will be down in the description as well as in the pinned comment if you want to check it out. All right, so those of you who don't know who Gary Vaynerchuk is, or he goes by Gary Vee. Gary Vee is somebody who, you know, he's an immigrant and he helped build his father's wine business, and now he owns his own company. And pretty much he, you know, does a lot of speaking and does daily content and all that stuff. But anyways, there's a lot of people who don't like Gary Vee, and I'm definitely one of those people. Like, he kept popping up everywhere I was looking. And it was right around the time I started my YouTube channel and was trying to like grow this thing and all that. He kept popping up everywhere. And I'm gonna make a video more in depth on this later, but like, I absolutely hated motivational speakers. I just hated them, you know? And a lot of it is because of my own personal skepticism and, you know, trust issues and all of those things, right? And Gary Vee, you know, even though he has a massive audience, he still has a lot of people that don't like what he does. And in this video, I wanted to talk about something that I think, you know, we can pull from this and try to improve our own mental and emotional well-being. So I was going through some Gary Vee clips to try to find what I was looking for, but I actually came across this, and I think this brings up an amazing topic.
Something that I know is fundamentally universal for everybody there, anybody in this room. One thing that I know is fundamentally universal is that nobody is gonna cry for you. They have their own tears. One thing I'm positive about is how ROI negative complaining is and how much I'm trying to suffocate the practice of it. I really have been fascinated by people that have changed their mindset into understanding that everything that is not going well right now is their fault.
Boom, right there, okay? So what Gary Vee is talking about right there is like this like sense of entitlement, okay? And this is something that so many of us struggle with. And here's the thing, there is a psychological theory which talks about locus of control, okay? So something that Gary Vee talks about is everything's my fault. Everything is my fault, okay? And what that is that's locus of control. So people who have an external locus of control, they believe that external sources are pretty much what depicts their destiny, okay? If you're not doing well enough or anything like that, or if you're going to succeed, it's based on all these external factors, okay? Studies have proven that people with an external locus of control are more depressed as well as more anxious. And think about it. It's because you feel like you have no control over your own, you know, your own destiny, if you will. You know what I mean? But people who have an internal locus of control, they are people who get into the solution because they believe that everything that happens is a result of what they're doing, okay? People with an internal locus of control have less signs of depression and less signs of anxiety because they are taking accountability, all right? So I'm actually reading a book right now, and it's called The Subtle Art of Not Giving a F, right? And this has been recommended to me forever, but I looked at this book, I'm like, I don't wanna read this. It probably doesn't have any science or anything like that. Like, I need proof. I need proof from somebody, right? But it's actually a phenomenal book, and he dives into a lot of science and psychology and things like this, but it's also really funny. But anyways, one of the parts I just recently left off on was this entitlement, right? And it got me thinking about Gary Vee and how this affects our mental health. And so many of us are entitled. So there's two sides of entitlement, right? And here's something that a lot of people struggle with is I feel like I'm the best thing on earth and I'm the worst, right? So, and both of those come with their own set of entitlement. And this is something that Gary Vaynerchuk touches on a lot. So there's this entitlement, and the way Gary Vee talks about it is like the audacity that people have, right? So on one side of entitlement, it's almost narcissistic in the way. It's like, I'm the best thing since sliced bread, right? I am so amazing, I deserve everything. Like, why do I even have to work for this thing? Because I deserve everything. You don't understand how amazing I am or what I have to offer. I deserve this, right? You see this happening, you know, even in the dating scene. I haven't been in the dating scene for a couple of years now, but you see people like that, right? Like, I'm so beautiful. You would be lucky. You would be lucky to have me, right? So there's a balance between like confidence and being like a cocky D-bag, right? But on the opposite end of entitlement is people who are the victim, right? And this is something that I was, just constantly the victim, you know? So as the son of an alcoholic mom, as you know, a kid who, you know, had traumatic experiences, you know, all the things that I went through in my life, this world owed me something, right? If you knew how difficult my life was, you would just hand me everything. You know what I mean? And this is something that I know a lot of you struggle with too. Maybe a lot of you have overcome that because here at the Rewired Soul, we talk about the problem, but we focus on the solution. Because the longer we sit around and think that this world owes us something, we are running a fool's errand. I sat in misery for so many years, causing my own suffering because I felt like this world owed me something. And one of the biggest aha moments that I had was this world and its people doesn't owe me a damn thing. Let me repeat that for the people in the back. This world and its people does not owe you a damn thing, all right? And once we start recognizing that, then we start taking control of our own lives. Then we start improving our mental health. So, when I was first starting out on my recovery journey, both from my addiction as well as, you know, improving my mental health, you know, my sponsor or a mentor, if you will, he taught me something that's actually in my book, Rewire Your Anger, where he showed me how many things were my fault. How many things, right? I had a list, you know, this part of an inventory and self-reflection, writing down all these things that were pissing me off, right? And he would always ask me, he's like, Chris, did you make any decisions that put you in that situation, right? So when we're talking about ex-girlfriends, when we're talking about jobs that I've lost, when we're talking about all these other things, like when I traced those breadcrumbs back, there was one common denominator, and that was me. All right? Like, why were these things happening to me? You know? And don't get me wrong, there are things completely outside of your control. You know, like, for example, me being the son of an alcoholic mother, outside of my control, okay? I did not control that in any way, shape, or form. But you know what I did control? How long I chose to blame her and sit in that misery and not improve my own life. How long I sat and chose to blame her while it was affecting people like my son, my kid's mom, my friends, my other family members, my coworkers, my bosses, and all those things, because I was sitting in that and not getting in the solution. The longer I held on to that resentment, it was affecting everybody else. So while I didn't have control over my mom or my upbringing, I did have control of me sitting in the problem. Now, I know it's easier said than done. When Gary Vee talks, it's easier said than done. But let me tell you all right now, it is the most empowering thing that will ever happen in your life, okay? When you look at your current situation, when you look and you notice that you are not in a place where you are happy, okay? And then you say, what can I do about this? What is in my control? What is in this internal locus of control? Your life starts to get amazing, all right? So living this way, I no longer blame people, places, or situations for my outcomes, all right? You know what I do? I double down, I work harder, and I look to improve these things. So many of us, so many of you out there who watch this is something that I used to struggle with as well, is that I blamed my poor mental health on everybody and everything, right? If my mom would just be this way, if my dad would just be this way, if my boss would just be this way, if my job would just be this way, if the customers would just be this way, if my friends would just be this way, all these other things, right? And that is staying in the problem, right? Some of you are sitting there in your own misery right now, blaming everybody else for how you feel, okay? And this is something that we have to stop doing. Because, like I always say, it's a lot easier for us to fix us and the way that we perceive the world than it is to try to fix everybody else. Because trying to fix everybody else is, again, running a fool's errand. Think about the last time somebody really got you to change. You know what I mean? And think about how hard it was if you're somebody who has been fortunate enough to change. So why don't we take control back, work on ourselves, and analyze every situation and say, what can I do about this? What is in my control? Okay, you don't like your job? Guess what? You can quit that job. Now, it comes with some consequences. Maybe you're gonna make less money. Maybe you're gonna be behind on some bills, right? But you are in control. The more you realize that you are in control, I promise you, your life is gonna get better, all right? So while a bunch of people do hate Gary Vee for calling them out on their crap and suffocating these excuses, it is one of the best things that can happen in your life when you start suffocating your own excuses, all right? But anyways, don't forget, Rewire Your Anger is now available over on Audible, so go check it out if you haven't yet, all right? And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge, huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And over on Patreon, don't forget, if you're at the $20 tier or up, all my books are free, so make sure you go check the post because I uploaded them over there, all right? Thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.